Hey guys, how's it going? Today I'm going to be showing you how I made this awesome pumpkin cutout just in time for the fall season. We do have the plans available for this on our website, so be sure to check those out. There's a link down in the description. Without further ado, let's show you how I made it.
Starting in a new project here to make a stacked pumpkin cutout for the fall season. We do have the plans available on our website, so be sure to check those out there. We're just getting the Oramask laid down on top of this material that I painted orange. And then we're putting it on the StepCraft M1000 CNC machine and using some brad nails to hold it down. Picking up the 46202-K quarter inch downcut bit to cut out the majority of the waste here. So with the Vetric software that we also sell on our website, you can do a large area clearance toolpath on a pocket toolpath. So basically I have three bits here that I'm going to be using in varying sizes to get down to the detail that we need. If you love this type of content, be sure to subscribe to our channel and go ahead and hit that bell so that you'll be notified on all of the new videos when they're released. Also, don't forget to follow us on Instagram at ToolsToday. With the Oramask, it's extremely important that we use a downcut bit here, as the downcut forces all of the chips down and does not pull the masking away. If you use an upcut bit here, it will just sit there and tear the mask up, which is not what we want. This masking is going to help us get a nice painted edge without having to do a ton of work with it. So we got the 46200-K picked up, so that way we can get the finer details cut out. This bit is a 1/8 inch in diameter, so it's going to go into the areas that the quarter inch diameter bit could not get into. So we're just filling out all of those small details. Again, with that down cut bit, it's leaving that nice clean top surface, which is exactly what you want to see when you're using Oramask like this. So we're going through and getting all of that done with the larger area pockets, and then we're going to get that switched out for the 1/16 inch bit. This is the 46233-K, and that is a 1/16 inch down cut bit. So then this is going to go into all those really, really fine detail areas that only this bit is able to get into. That large area clearance toolpath on the pocket with the Vetric software is definitely a really nice feature to have and definitely speeds up this process. So we got all of that cut out there. So now we just need to cut the profile. I'll switch out for the 46176-K 1/8 inch compression bit. A compression bit has a upcut portion at the bottom and a downcut portion at the top of the bit. So it leaves a clean cut on the top and bottom surface of the material as long as that first pass is below the upcut portion of the bit. If it's just touching the upcut portion, it'll be just like using an upcut bit and may tear out the surface finish. So we got that all cut out and we left some tabs here on the back so we can get that all pulled off. I'll use the fine Multi-Master cordless multi-tool to cut out all of those tabs. So now that that is free, we can stand up the piece and see what we've got going on. Really like the way that this looks, and it'll definitely look awesome with the paint. You can see that chip out free cut on the top and bottom surface that we got with the compression bit. So now I've got the MR0110 mini roundover bit. This bit has a 3/16 inch diameter ball bearing that's able to get into all of those really fine corners left by that 1/8 inch compression bit. This is definitely something that most bits are not able to do and eliminates all the sanding that would be necessary when you have tight corners like that. So there was a little area here that popped off while I was vacuuming it up. I actually vacuumed this piece off, so I needed to remake that with just an X-Acto knife, so that way the paint doesn't get on the orange surface. Got some gloves, and we'll get the paint all put on the masking where we cut out. So we're just using some black paint here. This is an outdoor paint since this will go outdoors. And then I'm using some green General Finishes milk paint and emerald. So we got the masking all pulled off. This is one of the most satisfying sounds ever, so I'll let you guys listen to that. I definitely love the way that this looks. I'm not sure that there's anything more satisfying than seeing this masking all get pulled off. I absolutely love the way that this is turning out. Using the downcut bit with the Oramask leaves really crisp edges on there, so we have no cleanup work needed to do at all after we pull this masking off. So now that this one is done, we can get it set up in its final location at the house. And I absolutely love the way that this piece turned out. As I said before, we do have the plans available on our website, so be sure to check those out there. I'm gonna let Katie do a bit of a sign-off. She was talking for Eli at the end, and this is actually the first video that Eli will be in, so definitely kind of a cool one. But anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed this project. We'll catch you guys back out here in the next one. Have a great day, everybody. You think that's an Eli pumpkin?
Because Eli's just natural.
Yeah? Which one's a Katie pumpkin? What are the other two?
Mama and Dada.
Yeah, we have a family pumpkin stack. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you love this type of content, be sure to subscribe right over here. And for more great videos, click right over here.